Ladies and gentlemen, the Vice President and the Secretary of State, accompanied by the Vice President of the People's Republic of China.
Seated, and it's an honor to welcome all of you to the State Department this afternoon. It's always good to have Vice President Biden here, and we are particularly pleased to have our very special guest of honor. I'd also like to recognize Ming Tsai, the talented chef who has prepared this delicious lunch for us, fusing the flavors of Chinese and American cuisine.
各位好，每当能够请到拜登总统光临这里，我们感到非常的高兴。特别是我们的贵宾习近平副主席，今天也到这里，我们感到非常的欢迎。欢迎诸位光临国务院。我还要借此表彰厨艺高超的蔡明厨师，是他为我们烹制了这餐融中美风味于一体的佳肴。This
year marks the 40th anniversary of President Nixon's historic trip to China. And we are very pleased that Dr. Kissinger is here with us, who along with Zhou Enlai was instrumental in transforming the relationship between our two countries.
今年正值尼克松总统历史性的中国之行的40周年，而今天我们也感到非常的高兴。 在座的还有基辛格博士，他和周恩来在上个世纪70年代共同迈出的步伐，从根本上改变了中美两国的关系。Today,
cooperation between the United States and China is imperative to address the many vexing challenges we face, from countering proliferation to addressing climate change to promoting global economic security. Now, developing the habits of cooperation is not easy. We have a lot of work to do, but we are both committed to building a lasting framework of trust that will support a cooperative partnership for the next 40 years and beyond.
如今，我们两国的合作是解决我们面临的挑战所不可或缺的，从防扩散到应对气候变化。 到促进全球经济安全都是如此，而培养合作的习惯不是轻而易举的，我们有很多的工作要做，但是我们两国政府都致力于打造一种持久的信任。Vice
President Xi first came to the United States on an exchange program over 25 years ago to Iowa. He will travel there tomorrow to see some old friends. That visit illustrates how important the bonds between our people are. That's why we support programs like 100,000 Strong to send more American students to study in China, and many more people-to-people exchanges.
而这种信任在今后的40年乃至更长的时间中，将在为我们的伙伴关系的不断成长提供支持。 习副主席25年前曾经参加美中交流计划访问过美国，本周他还会前往爱奥瓦州去探访一些老朋友。他的爱奥瓦州之行表明，通过交流结成的纽带是非常重要的。也正因为如此，我们两国政府承诺出台万人交流计划，让更多的美国学生到中国去留学。这样做的收益。
So it is a great pleasure to welcome Vice President Xi and to celebrate the bonds of friendship between our nation's governments and peoples. And it is now my great honor to introduce Vice President Biden.
Well, thank you all for being here, and it's an honor to welcome Vice President Xi along with the entire Chinese delegation.
感谢诸位，我感到非常荣幸能够欢迎习副主席所率领的中国代表团。
I told Vice President Xi his visit to Iowa tomorrow will assure him more delegates than I got the last time I was here.
我跟习副主席说过，他明天对爱荷华州的访问将使得他在爱荷华州得到的选举人团的选票比我在爱荷华州得到的选票还多。
And Mr. Vice President, this is not part of the script, but Lindsey Graham is relieved you didn't show up in January. You may have won the Republican nomination.
而副主席先生，这个，我现在是脱稿跟您说 ，Lindsey Graham， 那么他呢，这个他当年呢是得到共和党提名的这个竞选人。
Secretary Kissinger, you can see formality is still my forte.
基辛格国务卿，你看你可以看出哈，我还是这个拘于形式的人。
Madam Secretary, this lunch is a great start. I hope we can match the extraordinary hospitality that the Vice President showed me in my four-day visit to China last August.
国务卿女士，今天是一个很好的开端，这是我们回报当我前一段对中国进行四天之行所受到的款待的第一步。
The highlight of that trip for me, Mr. Vice President, was the time we spent in conversation together in Beijing and Chengdu, and I look forward to continuing the conversations we started this morning over the next four days you're here.
而副主席先生，我对贵国的访问的高潮，实际上是我们共同在北京、在成都所进行的一系列的会话和对话，而我期待着在今后的四天中，能够在洛杉矶，在这里，在洛杉矶继续我们这样的对话。
The Vice President has already participated in three meetings prior to this lunch, and they've covered a broad range of constructive discussions. We have a very ambitious agenda in the coming days as well.
那今天副主席先生已经参加了三次会谈，这三次会谈，涉及到了非常广泛的问题。我们就这些广泛的问题进行了非常有建设性的讨论。
As the Vice President, I have discussed at some length, the United States and China have much to do together, quite frankly, because our relationship was literally going to help shape the 21st century.
正如我跟副主席先生所讨论的一样，我们美中两国要共同做的工作还非常非常的多，来共同打造能够这个来共同建设能够打造二十一世纪的这种关系。
We're not only the world's two largest economies, we're both Pacific powers, and every day the affairs of our nations and the livelihoods of our citizens grow more connected.
我们两国是世界上最大的经济体，都是同属太平洋大国，我们国家人民的生活，我们国家各自国家的事务都在影响着世界。
The President and I came to office determined to rebalance America's strategic priorities toward those regions that are most critical to our nation's future. And that meant refocusing on Asia, the most dynamic region of the global economy.
奥巴马总统和我入主白宫的时候，我们就决心要这个对那些对于美国的未来能够发生关键作用的这些地区，我们要重新把精力集中于这些地区。
And to state the obvious, the U.S.-China relationship is a critical component of our broader Asian strategy. Our people, both American and Chinese, are indeed people all, quite frankly, people all around the world will benefit from this mutual effort to build a more cooperative partnership between our countries.
而很显然，我们与中国的关系，我们与贵国的这种双边关系，是我们在亚洲的战略的非常重要的一部分。我们美中两国人民，而这种关系对于美中两国人民乃至世界人民都会造福。
I first visited China in 1979. And the prosperity achieved since then, which I saw as recently as this past August is, as all of you know who visited, stunning, absolutely stunning.
我第一次访华是在1979年，而从那以来，中国在繁荣方面所取得的进展，那是我在八月访华期间再次目睹的，这也是在座诸位所知的。这种在繁荣方面所取得的进展是令人瞩目的。
Few other nations in history have come so far, so fast, and it's a great credit to the talent and industriousness of the Chinese people.
在历史上，很少有能够在这么短的时间，在经济发展这么快的国家，而贵国的这些飞速的发展，都要归功于中国人民的勤劳和智慧。
But I respectfully suggest that this remarkable growth did not occur in a vacuum. It was cultivated at every turn by an international system that enables rapid development, grounded in rules that apply with equal measure to all nations.
不过，我也非常带有富有敬意的提醒诸位，贵国的这种成就不是在真空中所取得的。它是基于一个井然有序的世界体系的，它是基于这适用于各国所有国家的规则的。
Mr. Vice President, even as our cooperation grows, as we've discussed, the United States and China will continue to compete. And as Americans, we welcome competition. It's part of our DNA, and it propels our citizens to rise to the challenge.But cooperation, as you and I have spoken about, can only be mutually beneficial if the game is fair.
习副主席，正如我们在讨论中所说的，我们美中两国的合作正在不断的增进，而在这个过程中，美中两国也将继续保持竞争，而我们美国人是欢迎竞争的，因为竞争。毕竟是属于是在我们的基因之中，我们是愿意面迎接挑战的，而我们的这种合作，这一定要是互利才行。
That's why in the meetings we've had this morning were essentially a continuation of the multiple meetings we had in your country in August, and we spent a great deal of time discussing the areas of our greatest concern.Including the need to rebalance the global economy, to protect intellectual property rights and trade secrets, to address China's undervalued exchange rate, to level the competitive playing field, to prevent the forced transfer of technology, and to continue a constructive dialogue on policies that would benefit our citizens and the world.
也正是因为如此，我们今天上午所举行的会谈，实际上是我八月份访华中多种会谈的继续。那我们花了很多时间讨论了我们所关注的若干领域，这包括要在全球经济中实现再平衡，要对知识产权以及商业秘密提供更好的保护，要改进人民币和美元之间的汇率，以及要营造一个公平的环境、竞争环境。另外要减少那些强迫外来公司进行技术转让的这种做法等等。而这种建设性的讨论，我们将继续进行下去，以便使得我们能够推出能够造福于我们国家人民的政策。
While the United States and China, as you have pointed out, Mr. Vice President, will not always see eye to eye, it is a sign of the strength and maturity of our relationship that we can be candid about our differences as we have been.
习副主席，正如您所指出的一样，美中两国并不是在所有问题上都完全意见一致。不过呢，这是我们这种关系在不断在加强以及不断成熟的一个迹象。它表明我们可以诚挚地讨论彼此之间存在的问题和分歧。
We saw this in the recent UN Security Council debate about Syria, where we strongly disagreed with China and Russia's veto of a resolution against the unconscionable violence being perpetrated by the Assad regime.
这种情况最近在联合国安理会有关叙利亚决议的辩论中就可见一斑。这个我们俄罗斯和中国否决了要停止叙利亚政府对其人民进行暴力活动的有关的决议，对此我们表示极度的不赞成。
And as was brought up by the president in his meeting with you and my meeting with you as well, we see our advocacy for human rights as a fundamental aspect of our foreign policy, and we believe a key to the prosperity and stability of all societies.
而正如我跟副主席以及奥巴马总统跟副主席先生在会谈中所提出的一样，我们认为人权是我们美国外交政策的一个重要领域，而人权问题也是一个国家，人权也是一个国家稳定和繁荣的重要组成部分。
We have been clear about our concern over the areas in which, from our perspective, conditions in China have deteriorated, and about the plight of several very prominent individuals. We appreciate your response.
而我们在会谈中也表明了我们对若干个人他们在中国境遇的这个情况的关注，也感激您对这些我们所提出的关注所做的回应。
Despite our differences, China and the United States are working more closely together on a broader range of issues than ever before.
尽管我们两国存在分歧，但是我们两国现在在更加广泛的问题上来进行着合作，这都超出了以往。
These include pressing security challenges, North Korea and Iran, maritime security.Cybersecurity, and the important work of developing cooperation between our militaries.
那这些领域包括安全，包括北朝鲜问题，包括伊核问题，包括海上安全问题，以及包括还有包括电脑网络安全，还有就是我们两军的关系问题。
As you and the President briefly discussed in the Oval Office, it also includes our efforts in Sudan and in South Asia and on global issues such as climate change and nuclear security.
而正如您在椭圆办公室跟奥巴马总统所讨论的一样，这些问题还包括苏丹问题，包括南亚问题，这个包括还包括核安全问题等等。
We appreciate your candid responses as we discuss these issues, Mr. Vice President, and I believe you appreciate ours as well.
而对于您所表现的坦诚，我们表示我们非常感谢和赞赏。我们相信呢，在我们这种讨论中，您也会赞赏我们的坦诚。
So, Mr. Vice President, once again, welcome to the United States. I've always believed that the best way sometimes the only way to truly understand a country is to see it with your own eyes. As you know, there's an old Chinese saying, better to travel 10,000 miles than read 10,000 books.
那习副主席，我想再次对您表示欢迎，欢迎您光临美国。我们认为，了解一个国家的最佳方式就是亲自到一个国家去，亲眼去看那个国家。正如中国一句成语所说的 远行千里路，胜读万卷书。
Although I read Dr. Kissinger's book on China,
当然我所读的有关中国的书是基辛格博士所写的。
I felt that my trip to your country was at least as important last summer.
不过我认为我对贵国的访问就像基辛格博士当年的访问一样重要。
Actually, Mr. Vice President, I can't thank you enough for the hospitality you extended to me and my trip, and I would like to, with your permission, propose a toast.
那习副主席，对于在我在访华期间您所给予我的热情款待，我真是感激不尽。借此呢，我想请诸位跟我举杯祝酒。
A toast to a successful visit for the Vice President and the increase in cooperation understanding that will help both our nations continue to increase this relationship and may it benefit not only us, but the whole world.
那为习副主席美国之行成功祝酒，为我们不断加深合作、加强合作、加深了解，使得我们能够继续营造这种造福于两国人民乃至造福于世界人民的关系，为之祝酒。
Mr. Vice President.
尊敬的副总统先生，尊敬的国务卿女士，女士们、先生们、朋友们，很高兴啊，能够出席拜登副总统和克林顿国务卿共同为我和我的同事举办的午宴。我此次是应拜登副总统邀请访问美国，是对拜登副总统去年八月成功访华的回访，旨在落实两国元首的共识，增进中美战略互信，拓展务实合作，深化人民友谊，进一步的推进中美合作伙伴关系建设。
Mr. Vice President, Madam Secretary,Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, it gives me great pleasure to attend this luncheon hosted jointly by Vice President Biden and Secretary Clinton for me and my colleagues. Last August, Vice President Biden paid a successful visit to China. I'm now in the United States on a return visit at his kind invitation. The purpose of my visit is to implement the agreement between our two presidents.Enhance China-U.S. strategic trust, broaden practical cooperation, deepen people-to-people friendship, and further advance the cooperative partnership between our two countries.
今年是尼克松总统访华，中美上海公报发表40周年。40年前啊，两国的领导人以政治家的超凡勇气和远见卓识，推开了尘封多年的中美交往大门。40年来，中美关系虽然历经风雨，但始终向前发展，取得了历史性的成就，给两国和两国人民带来了巨大的利益，也有力地维护和促进了亚太乃至世界的和平、稳定和繁荣。中美关系已经成为当今世界最重要的、最富活力的和潜力的双边关系之一。饮水不忘掘井人。今天，当我们共享中美关系发展成果之时，要感谢为开创中美关系历史新局面做出卓越贡献的两代领导人，两国几代领导人，也要感谢为中美关系发展付出大量心血和智慧的两国各界的友人，包括在座的许多新老朋友。
This year marks the 40th anniversary of President Nixon's visit to China and the issuance of the Shanghai Communique. 40 years ago, with the extraordinary courage and vision of statesmen, The leaders of our two countries opened the door of China-US exchanges that had been sealed off for years. Despite some twists and turns over the past four decades, China-US relations have kept moving forward, scoring achievements of historic proportions. The growth of China-US relations has brought huge benefits to the two countries and two peoples, and lent a strong impetus to peace, stability, and prosperity in the Asia-Pacific region and the world at large. China-US relationship has become one of the most important, dynamic, and promising bilateral relationships in the world. As the saying goes, when you drink water, don't forget those who dug the well. Today, when we enjoy the fruit of China-US relations, we should be grateful to the generations of Chinese and American leaders for their outstanding contribution to the new chapter in the annals of China-US relations. We should also be grateful to the Chinese and American friends from various sectors, including many who are present today, for the painstaking and resourceful efforts they have made for the development of China-US relations.
奥巴马政府执政三年来，中美关系总体保持积极发展的势头。去年一月，胡锦涛主席访问美国，并同奥巴马总统就共同努力建设相互尊重、互利共赢的中美合作伙伴关系达成了重要的共识，为中美关系长远发展指明了方向。我们高兴地看到，两国各领域务实合作不断深化，在一系列重大国际地区和全球性问题上的沟通协调富有成效。
In the past 3 years during the Obama administration, China-US relations have on the whole maintained positive momentum of growth. In January last year, President Hu Jintao paid a visit to the United States. He and President Obama reached important agreement on working together to build a China-US cooperative partnership based on mutual respect and mutual benefit, charting the course for the long-term development of China-US relations. We are glad to see that the two countries have further deepened practical cooperation in a wide array of areas and carried out productive communication and coordination on a range of major international, regional, and global issues.
今天上午，我在白宫同奥巴马总统、拜登副总统举行了会见会谈，我们就中美关系和共同关心的重大问题深入地交换了意见，达成了不少新的重要共识。我们认为，双方要始终抓住共同利益这一主线，走出一条大国之间和谐相处、良性互动、合作共赢的新型合作伙伴之路。为此，双方应坦诚相待，加强对话沟通，相互尊重，增进战略互信，与时俱进，扩大务实合作，面向未来，密切人民的交往，加强协作，应对挑战。
This morning, I had a meeting with President Obama and held talks with Vice President Biden at the White House. We had an in-depth exchange of views on bilateral relations and major issues of shared interest, and reached a lot of new and important consensus. We all believe that the two sides should focus on our common interests and open a new path of cooperative partnership between major countries, featuring harmonious coexistence, sound interactions, and win-win cooperation. To this end, our two sides should treat each other with sincerity and candor and enhance dialogue and communication. We should respect each other and strengthen strategic mutual trust. We should keep pace with the times and expand practical cooperation. We should look ahead to the future and step up people-to-people exchanges. And we should intensify coordination and work together to meet challenges.
我同奥巴马总统、拜登副总统着重谈了经贸问题。我们认为，在国际经济、金融形势依然严峻，中美两国都面临保增长、调结构、促就业任务的大背景下，双方应继续同舟共济、共克时艰，加快建设全面互利的经济伙伴关系，维护两国和世界经济稳定复苏和增长，不断挖掘合作潜力，打造合作亮点，推动两国贸易投资朝着更加平衡的方向发展，以对话协商而非保护主义的方式处理彼此经贸关切，努力维护中贸经贸合作互利共赢的基本格局。
President Obama, Vice President Biden and I devoted the greater part of our discussion on economic and trade issues. We share the view that as the international economic and financial situation remains grim, and as ensuring growth, adjusting structure, and promoting employment are high on the domestic agenda of both countries, we must continue to make concerted efforts to tide over difficulties, accelerate the building of the comprehensive and mutually beneficial economic partnership, and maintain steady economic recovery and growth in both countries and the world as a whole. We should tap our cooperation potential, create more bright spots in our cooperation, and strive for greater balance in trade and investment between the two countries. We should address each other's economic and trade concerns through dialogue and consultation, not protectionism, and uphold the mutually beneficial pattern of China-US economic relations and trade.
我们还就人权等问题开诚布公交换了意见。我强调，改革开放三十多年来，中国人权事业取得了有目共睹的巨大成就，但在人权问题上没有最好，只有更好。中国人口多，区域差异大，发展不平衡，在进一步改善民生和人权状况方面还面临不少的挑战。中国政府将继续从本国国情出发，坚持以人为本，始终把人民愿望和要求放在心上，采取切实有效的政策措施，大力促进社会公平、正义与和谐，推动中国人权事业不断取得新的进展。同时，我们也愿在平等和相互尊重的基础上，与包括美国在内的世界各国就人权问题开展坦诚建设性的对话和交流，增进了解，缩小分歧，相互借鉴，共同进步。
We also had a candid exchange of views on human rights and other issues. I stressed that China has made tremendous and well-recognized achievements in the field of human rights over the past 30-plus years since reform and opening up. Of course, there is always room for improvement when it comes to human rights. Given China's huge population, considerable regional diversity, and uneven development, we are still faced with many challenges in improving people's livelihood and advancing human rights. The Chinese government will always put people's interests first and take seriously people's aspirations and demands. We will, in the light of China's national conditions, continue to take concrete and effective policies and measures to promote social fairness, justice, and harmony, and push forward China's cause of human rights. At the same time, we are ready to conduct candid and constructive dialogue and exchanges on human rights with the United States and other countries on the basis of equality and mutual respect, with a view to enhancing understanding, narrowing differences, learning from each other, and achieving common progress.
中美作为世界上最大的发展中国家和最大的发达国家，建设新型合作伙伴关系是一项具有重要和深远意义的开创性工作。 既没有先例可循，也没有经验可鉴，只能如邓小平先生所言，摸着石头过河，或者如克林顿国务卿所言，逢山开路，遇水搭桥。中国有句流行的歌的歌词是这样唱的：敢问路在何方，路在脚下。我相信中美双方完全有智慧、有能力、有办法维护和发展好相互尊重、互利共赢的合作伙伴关系，为不同政治制度、历史文化背景和经济发展水平的国家建设积极合作关系，树立前无古人但后起来者的典范。
China is the world's largest developing country, while the United States is the largest developed country. To build a new type of cooperative partnership between two countries like ours is a pioneering endeavor with great and far-reaching significance. There is no precedent for us to follow and no ready experience for us to refer to. We can only do what Mr. Deng Xiaoping said, cross the river by feeling the stones.Or what Secretary Clinton once quoted, when confronted by mountains, one finds a way through. When blocked by a river, one finds a way to bridge to the other side. A Chinese pop song goes like this. May I ask where the path is? It is where you take your first step. I'm convinced that China and the United States have the wisdom, ability, and means.To maintain and develop their cooperative partnership based on mutual respect and mutual benefit. And by doing so, we'll set an unprecedented and inspiring example for countries with different political systems, histories, cultures, and levels of economic development to cultivate positive and cooperative relations.
最后我提议，为拜登副总统和克林顿国务卿以及在座各位朋友的身体健康，为中美关系40年来取得的巨大发展，为中美关系的美好明天，干杯。
I now propose a toast to the health of Vice President Biden and Secretary Clinton, and that of all the friends present, to the remarkable development of China-US relations in the past 40 years, and to an even better tomorrow.Of China-US relations. Cheers.